Howdy Monster Hunters, and welcome to part 8 of my Road to Master Hunter's Crest. And yes, I'm actually attempting to do the Village Quest Alatreon, and my god, I cannot believe I actually done this with a katana. Now, I'll say for a fact that quite a few people have obviously done this online already, most noticeably with the Heavy Bow Gun and the Kelby Deershot Bow. Now, or Slingshot, however you want to call it really. Now, I've obviously tried it with the Kelby Deershot, and I couldn't for the life of me even remotely try and survive. I just couldn't do it at now. Originally, my plan was to go in there with a lance and try and either go in with the Rattlesnarl Z armor set, which was my main armor set, without, you know, without fail with any quest, it would be the one armor set I would go to all the time. But then since making the Isaac Naxor armor set, I thought, let me try that as well. Even though I did keep in mind that it has pretty rubbish fire resistance, and obviously Alatreon's a master of the other elements. Well, not necessarily a master as such, but he could easily use them just to take the mick. Now, it did take a while, I'm not going to lie. It took me quite a few attempts. This is most likely my fourth or fifth attempt at doing this quest, and I was quite surprised in my choice. I was actually thinking, what armor set should I go for? What would be better? And given that I would mainly get attacked by the fire and dragon elements from Alatreon, I came across Brachydios, and obviously it's got a decent amount of fire resistance. I think it was plus 20. Dragon is neutral, so it wasn't terribly bad. The defense overall wasn't too bad either. I don't think I had maxed out my armor set. I maxed out probably the head, the arms, and done a bit on the chest, and then I kind of went in with that. And I'm not gonna lie, it was incredibly difficult, considering how I kind of look back on myself on Portable Third. But Portable Third never really had any G rank difficulty monsters which were that difficult in terms of G rank strength. Obviously, given that Triultimate has G rank, but the quests themselves are high rank, it feels as though it's hitting like a G rank monster. Especially if you did the very last quest in the village, other than Alatreon, it was the Ivory Laggy Chris Picidios and one of the monster which has just slipped my mind, but it made it quite difficult to actually go through this quest. And obviously you can see here, one flash in the entire damn quest actually worked, and I had 15 in total, 5 combined and 10-2 combined, and one actually worked. And if it wasn't for the Ballista Binder in this quest, I don't know what I would have done with Alatreon being in the air like a doozy half the time. Unless being forced to more or less use a heavy bowgun or a light bowgun. I don't know how that would have turned out in all honesty, if I had to do that. But It was doable. It took a very long time, admittedly. A lot shorter than the actual video itself. I think definitely back in a certain time ago, I would have posted the entire thing, but you don't need to see pointless running around and doing this, doing that, la-di-da sort of stuff. So obviously we'll keep it short, concise, to the point where it's only entertaining stuff and stuff that makes everyone laugh. I think that had that quite a bit, especially with the gold Rathian charging whilst it was midair and then cutting the tail off. Always pleasurable to do that. Always. But obviously we're getting off topic here. We're talking about the Alatreon and how much of a pain it is. The fact that you can't use flash bombs. Yes, I'm still going on about the flash bombs even after the video was completed. I just don't know what else to say. Like, I really do miss the use of flash bombs, because they were without a doubt the one thing that is incredibly dire in a situation where life powders won't work. And when I say they won't work, is because even if you use the life powder, the monster will still either charge, attack, do something stupid, and then end up killing them even though they had a bit more health. and it's just using a flash bomb to stop a monster dead in its tracks, and then, you know, you can heal, you can run away, you can combine, you can strategize, whatever the heck you want to do. And it's just, I don't know, it's one of those things that I think will be sorely missed from Monster Hunter, at least in my eyes. I know some people, it's kind of a mixed opinion, and it's good that it's a mixed opinion, because obviously then it would be more or less useless to talk about, because everyone would think the same thing. Some people obviously don't mind it, they prefer it, they're used to it, the way they throw their flash bombs, and they kind of know how they're meant to throw it now. Other people like myself perhaps don't know how to throw them anymore, or kind of give up trying and then just not bother, which to be fair is what I'm doing more or less right now. Pitfall traps and power traps without a doubt are still amazing to use, so it's always good that that's still there and they haven't actually nerfed the traps themselves. So it's one of those things that we can just carry on using and then not have to use the flash bombs and such, so it helps, but not greatly. I think I am never ever going to do the Alatreon Village quest ever again. Without a doubt, I am never touching this quest unless there was some silly reason where I needed the Alatreon part and they took down the Tri-Ultimate servers, in which case I would be plentifully screwed, shall we say, for needing parts. I think when I'd carved it, I got quite a number of plates and scoops, but that was about it. You know, there wasn't really much else. But yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy my ramble and my little take on the Alatreon. Let me know what you think. Have you finished the Alatreon Village quest? Have you not? Have you attempted it? What did you think? Was it difficult? Was it easy? You know, what are your thoughts on it? What do you suggest going in with to make life a little bit easier? But yeah, there you go. I've got the final reward in terms of completed village quests. We've got Chief's Pipe and Ice's Pendants. So we have pretty much completed everything in the village. Woohoo! And obviously I've done everything 1 to 2 star. I will be finishing the 3 star and 4 star, because I think 3 star I just need to do some gathering quests, but that's about it. But I'm rambling on into the outro, so if you guys did enjoy this video, please leave a comment down below saying what you guys thought, your thoughts on how to fight Alatreon, and most importantly, 2 other videos you may have missed, please check them out and see what you guys think. If you enjoy them, give them a like too, drop them a comment, and share them around. But yes, that's myself out, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.